Evening. Yeah, so it is Saturday and oh boy, I have been drinking purging since 7 o'clock in the morning. The biggest headache, you have no idea, and I'm tired. I've just finished working out a little while ago and I don't know what to do now because I've just started drinking, but I don't know yet. I feel like I want to binge and purge more, and I also feel like I want to do some laxatives. And my God, I'm a fucking mess. Okay, so I was supposed to go shopping today, right? But like from the morning, Ding Dong, also known as my spouse, decides to make a day out of it, right? We were supposed to go have breakfast. Get the things we have to get because next week is on Wednesday. Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday. Sorry, the paper's always over there. Wednesday's the book fair, right? And so I'm gonna make some food for the book fair. You know, donate some food. And then the following day is Thursday, and it's the last day of school for her because she doesn't have school Friday. And I was gonna go ahead, they're doing like a little Easter party, so I have to make my daughter an Easter basket. And I was gonna make like little Easter buckets with like little goodies and stuff for the kids in her classroom. And I was gonna bake cupcakes and maybe cookies, but I think I'll just do the cupcakes or maybe the cookies. I don't know yet. I like to bake, so that doesn't matter to me. So that's what I was gonna do. I was gonna just get all the stuff ready, and this may be two videos, so I'm sorry. So I wanted to just do that. Get everything ready because I have to do it because his behind won't do it. The only thing I ask of the man is two things. Number one, wake yourself up if you know we have to go somewhere. I'm not your mother. We're not lovey-dovey like that. If you were my man, that'd be different. I would wake you up with kisses and coffee and breakfast and you know, when I'm in love, I'm in love and I love you, and that's not an issue for me. But we're not like that anymore, you know. We're on a totally different plane. So if you know we have to do certain things, what you can do is just get yourself up. Just it's like an incentive. Like it's like kind of telling me I care about you because he says it all the time. Well then show it to me. Well then, if you care about me, then you know that we have things to do. And it's not even like my shit. It's concerning our kid. So wake yourself up, have incentive, show to me that you matter and the things we have to do matter, and I will get up on my own, of my own accord. I mean, why don't you wake me up for a change? Even though that's impossible because I don't sleep, or when I do, I wake up like at the crack of dawn and start exercising. So, but yeah, he stayed his ass in the bed. And number two, either wake yourself up, or number two, just give me the money and I will go. I will gladly go and drive and do what I gotta do because I don't like shopping with him, and I don't mind with my kid. It's like my kid is different with him. My kid doesn't know how to act with the three of us. It's not. It's so triggering. My daughter, when it's just my daughter and myself, it is the best time. We have the greatest time. I become this other person. I become this other version of myself that's calm, that doesn't have an eating disorder, that's a mother, that's happy, that's attentive, that I don't know, I just step out of myself and become someone else. And it's great and I love it, and that's why I'm looking forward to just living alone again, because when I lived with her by ourselves, I had that, you know? Even though there was all this other crap going on, but I had that. And if you hear that bellowing in the background, that's her playing. When it's the three of us, forget about it. It's so triggering. It's so because She gets away with murder with him. She knows she can manipulate him because he doesn't want to feel bad. He'll get hard on her. And oh my God, that thing is so bright. I'm sorry. I have the worst headache ever, and it's like everything is just making it worse. I think I'm gonna have to drink a fucking laxative. What the hell was I saying? Yeah, he doesn't know how to bring down the hammer. You know, I'm the enforcer, so. He feels guilty. He'll scold her, and then he'll feel guilty about it, and then give her way, hence defeating the whole purpose of the scolding. And she knows that, and she plays it up. And so when it's the three of us, like today in the store, she just wants him. She wants to be carried. She wants to be babied. She's like so out of character for her, and it just makes me mad because I have to like put the brakes out to be like, look, you know, you're not her friend, you're her father, and he just doesn't get it. But anyways, the man didn't wake up on time. He didn't wake up. He didn't show any kind of incentive. So what happens? My daughter gets up. Now my daughter likes to play you know, with her little toys and stuff, and she likes to play make-believe and do you know, like get the toys and stage something she saw in a movie or a book or use her imagination, whatever. Like now she has this thing where she likes to make, she has this cat, and it's like a toy cat. And this was the toy cat that she took one time up to where my sister lives when we went on vacation one time. And the cat, she by mistake, they were driving around the street, and the cat, she dropped it out the window by mistake. And when they got home, you know, she was like bawling because she lost the cat. So we had to go back and drive in the streets and look for the cat. And somebody actually had ran the cat over, and the cat's eye popped out. So, you know, it was one of her favorite toys at the time. And she was really in tears and stuff. So I asked my sister for a button, and the only button she has was like one of these big black buttons. And so I had to sew like the button on the cat. So cat has one big black button eye, and you know, the tiny eye that it came with, and so that's the cat that she's playing with. And she makes that cat a villain, and she's like, oh, Mr. Calico, and he's like evil, and so that's what she does. So, you know, when my husband is here, he'll indulge in that, which that I appreciate. He'll have daddy time with her like that. He'll you know, do voices and play with her, although he doesn't like these new scenarios where she's doing evil, and she says it just like that, and she'll do ha 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 and the little laugh and all that stuff, and he doesn't like that. He's like, no, I don't like games like that. They have to be good guys. Everyone has to be a good guy. And my daughter straight up looked him in the face and was like, daddy, not everyone is a good guy. And he was like, so she got up, I made her breakfast. I am clanking pots and making a ruckus to see if this man will wake up, and this man does not wake up. Well, I'm triggered, I'm pissed, I am already from the night before just wanting something, and I said, fuck it, let me start binging. Then, you know, after she's finished with her breakfast, you know, she gets her toys, she hops on the bed, and she starts hopping on him and wakes him up, and then she starts playing with him, and from, you know, he's laying down sleeping and he's doing the voices, and she's just having a good old time. But she's already playing, she's already, you know, happy. So Ding Dong wakes up officially, and I'm in the middle of binging. Now let me tell you something, there's two times you don't want to fuck with me. Number one is when I'm binging. You want to go wait over there, and because I take my time and I make sure I get it all out of my system. And number two, when I'm purging, I have no time for you. The phone could be ringing, the house could be on fire, the fucking neighbor could be banging on the door, Ed McMahon with the fucking big check, you have won $1 million, could be at my door. No, bro, I got no time for that. I need to purge and I need to get it all out, and I have no time until it's all finished and it's all out of my system. So, he disrupts me during binge time. Now, when I'm with Mia, okay, you need to wake the fuck up. I mean, I when I'm in binge mode, I am a completely different person. I am a bitch. I am in a zone. You do not want to mess with me. I've had the cat try to snatch my food, and I've bopped that motherfucker on the head because he's you don't want to take from me when I'm binging, okay? And so the man interrupts me when I'm in binging, and he's like, oh, we have to go here today, right? And let me get up now and do this and that. And I'm like, what's your turn, partner? I need another hour. So he's playing with her, and he's like, yeah, but why do you do that now in the morning if you know we got stuff to do? Excuse me? Why you don't wake your ass up when you know we got stuff to do? Are you shitting me? What? No. And another thing, you just started playing with her. The child's hopes are up here. I mean, you're just gonna crush her little spirit and stop in the middle of the game and all that stuff. No, just like play with her and let me do what I gotta do, and that's it. We're going on 11 minutes. This is gonna be two videos. So yeah, finally I do what I gotta do, purge everything, whatever, and it's time to go. So yeah, I went out today and I can't stand shopping with the two of them because, you know, they become this thing, and it becomes like this spectacle, and I hate going to stores and seeing those kids that make all this ruckus and the parent does nothing, and it's like, oh my god, are you gonna smack that kid or do I have to do it for you? Like come on. And I don't want to be one of those people. I despise seeing kids like that. And I mean, handle your business, please. And I know if it was just him and her, it would probably be like that. You know, he would be one of those people that I would just want to smack. So, in the store, I mean, I barely got anything. I'm going to have to wrap it up on Monday. There's these shoes that I want. Oh my god. And I couldn't even get them because I hate shopping with my husband. He's just like... like, I don't know, like, go over there, do something. My God, why do men come with you when you want to go shopping? They don't help. They don't do anything. I mean, just give me the money. I don't get why it's such a fucking big thing to just put money in my hand. I mean, I think that I believe that he doesn't want to give me money because he thinks I'm going to go, like, buy a train ticket or something. Or be like that movie, Sleeping with the Enemy, and slowly plot my escape and go move to another state and cut all my hair off and like fake my death or something. I don't know. He just refuses to put money in my hand, and I hate it because I feel so, I mean, I'm not a man, but I would feel emasculated if I was a man, and I just feel like really small, and I hate it. I feel like crying. I hate asking for money. I hate asking him for anything that I need. I hate it so much. I feel so degrading and it feels degrading, and it feels, God, I just hate it, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it. And but yeah, that was today so far, and I've just been bitching and purging all damn day. I think I'm up to 6 times now, and I just want to keep going, and I have a huge headache. And I purged the last time, and then I went ahead and made a protein shake, and not the turkey shake, the nutrabiotic, the heavy shake. And I've had 2 bananas, so that's like 260 that I've had that I haven't purged. And I've worked out, and I've burned 500 calories. And so now, I don't know, I feel like I want to do some lax and get the stragglers out, and I don't know. But I've started drinking, so I don't know, because my husband, has told me that he is bringing a salad from his job, and his job is like known for the salads. They're like awesome, and now I really want it. And we've got some movies today, and now I feel like I want to watch movies and binge and purge, and stop drinking just so I can binge and purge. But I don't know what I want to do, honestly. God, I'm so tired of bulimia. I have biggest headache. It's like right here. It's behind my eye. I don't know if it's dehydration or potassium or all of the above. But I'm just tired. I'm tired of binging and purging. I'm tired of bulimia. I'm sick of it. And I'm sick of all this disordered thinking that I'm having. And I'll probably save that story for the next video. And which I really want to talk about that. And I want, God, please, I want honest feedback. Okay, guys, I'm gonna tell you some things, and I want you to be really, really honest. I want you to be brutally honest with me. And I want to know if also, for the moms out there, if you've also had these kind of feelings. So we're going on 15 minutes. I'm gonna cut it and shoot to the next one, and I'll be right back. Okay.